second camera, where is it showing? Because I'm not a blogger.
Let me see which one can view
all of it. This one.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good afternoon, Father. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
It is with joy that we gather this afternoon to celebrate the 35th anniversary of Educare. A theme of joy, a theme of beauty, a theme of glory. We welcome all of you to today's celebration. We understand that a bigger celebration will be tomorrow, but it is great that we are giving God his due honor and glory. We welcome to this celebration the CEO of this institution, Lady Al John, who is with us virtually. We also welcome his son, who is the key foundation to Educare, and who will be helping us today with the first reading, Mr. Escott John. I understand he's also online with us. We welcome the executives, the teachers, and other staff members, parents who are joining us virtually to this occasion. We're happy that as instructor, with her team, who do the day-to-day activities of this place, and the Reverend Sisters, who are here today to bless the occasion, that we all are happy to share in the joy of the Lord. It is our celebration of the season. It is a record-keeping event for this institution. It is a significant event that is happening in the season of Advent. And so we are happy to be filled with joy this day. We are happy to be entertained, and we are happy to call on God to receive his glory for all the marvelous things he has done in our lives. Let us joyfully now welcome one of us who leads us in a Latin Advent song, Adeste Fidelis, to be taken by Miss Alexandria Kefuwerin. Adeste.
Recording in progress.
Thank you.
and in the spirit of our gathering for this celebration, let us now prepare ourselves for this special encounter with God by calling to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Together now, let us go to page 4 and recite the glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Sufferings. We thank you for your kindness and ask you to free us from all evil, that we may serve you in happiness all our days. We make this prayer to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and rests with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You may be seated, please, and listen to the first reading to be taken by Mr. Esau John.
A reading from the first book of Kings, 1 Kings chapter 8, verses 55 to 61. King Solomon stood erect, and in a loud voice he blessed the whole assembly of Israel. Blessed be the Lord, he said, who has granted rest to his people of Israel, keeping all his promises. Of all the promises of good that he made through Moses his servant, not one has failed. May the Lord our God be with us, as he was with our ancestors. May he never desert us or cast us off. May he turn our hearts towards him so that we may follow all his ways and keep the commandments. May these words of mine, of my entreaty before the Lord, be present with the Lord our God day and night, that he may uphold the cause of his servant and the cause of Israel, his people, as each day requires, so that all the people of the earth may come to know that the Lord is God indeed, and that there is no other. May your hearts be holy with the Lord our God, following his laws and keeping his commandments as at this present day. This is the word of the Lord.
And now we shall take the responsorial psalm to be taken by Reverend Sister Amaka Ojani.
I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness and love.
Thank you. Jesus went on to say, the kingdom of God is like this. Man scatters seed in his field. He sleeps at night, he's up, and about during the day, and all the while he sees are spreading and growing, yet he does not know how it happens. The soil itself makes the plants grow and bear fruit. First the tender stalk appears, then the ear, and finally the ear become. When the corn is ripe, the man starts cutting it with sickle, because harvest time has come. What shall we say the kingdom of God is like? Ask Jesus. What parable shall you use to explain it? Is it like this? Man takes a mustard seed, the smallest seed in the world, and plants it in the ground. After a while, it grows up and becomes the biggest of all plants. It puts out such large branches that the birds come and make their nests in its shade. Jesus preached this message to the people using many parables like this. He told them as much as they could understand. He could not speak to them without using parables. But when he was alone with the disciples, he would explain everything to them. The gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, Lord Jesus. By the hearing of the gospel, may our sins be washed away. Please be seated.
Once again, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. It is a thing of joy to be here. And because it is a thing of joy, our hearts are filled with gratitude because we are doing the right thing. And the pastries are record-keeping locations. When people mark gigantic strides along their journeys. Most often people do 10 years anniversary, silver jubilee anniversary, golden jubilee anniversary, diamond jubilee anniversary, or as you would like it. Today we have a great celebration to thank God for the 35th anniversary of this great institution. It is something worth doing because of his story. The gospel we heard from the Gospel of Mark told us the story of the mustard seed, and that appears to be the story of Ezekiel. Briefly, when we arrived, we were ushered into the office of the administrator, and we got talking. And she told us the phases this institution has taken, how it started. That Lady John, at a point in time, was thinking of where to keep his son, the one that took the first reading for us, Mr. Esco John, how to train him in school. I started thinking about having a nursery school in line with some other parents who may wish to have a very noble place, a standardized institution where children could be well formed and trained. And that's how the nursery school started. From being what it was, doing so well, it transformed into giving us a primary school fraction of secondary school. And what that kind of illustration could you use other than the mustard seed? I remember Mother Angelica, the one who founded the EWTN television channel. She started in a garage, thinking of what to do, how to use the television to spread the gospel. And they were looking for space, looking for accommodation, looking for equipment. They started small, in a garage. And today, EWTN is a global trend, a brand in every home. So big things begin small. And what it shows is that when God wants to perform miracles, He uses ordinary things in an extraordinary way. So He used Mr. Escott John as a miracle child that has today given us this great institution. In line with other institutions we celebrate. And since the years have gone, from year one, year two, year three, year four, year five, up to this day, that is 35 years of his foundation, Lady John, in line with the administration of this place, felt we can't say it is us alone. It is appropriate to return gratitude to God. Let us call on friends. Let us call on students. Let us call on parents. Let us all come and say, thank you, God, for doing it. The psalm of today presents us with the reason why we are here. And it is on it that the big problem we are having is focused upon. It says, I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness and love. This is the key disposition that every Christian who understands the presence of God in his or her life should always echo, should always have. Because God is ever faithful. God is ever steadfast. God is ever at work to better our environment, to make our climate resound with his beauty, to give us the best that we could ever wish. And so the psalmist this day tells us, I thank you, Lord, with all my heart. You have heard the words of my mouth. Before the angels, I will bless you. I will adore before your holy temple. We all are here doing nothing but adoring God. Before his holy temple, before his angels, all of us are singing praises to him in acknowledgement of the greatness that he has bestowed on this institution that began like a mustard seed. And all of us are participants in the storyline. We are witnesses to the miracle of Elohim. We are here offering God sacrifice, thanksgiving, something that comes from us with songs and praise, with prayers and pigeon to say, Lord, we return gratitude to you. And the service continues and says, I thank you for your faithfulness and love, which excel all we ever knew of you. On the day I called, you answered. You increased the strength of my soul. This is a conviction. This is an assurance. And this is the story of Elohim. And this is the story of Lady John. And this is our own story. The story of all that have passed through this place. A thing of joy. A thing of beauty. Something that lasts forever. You and I are privileged to be witnesses to today's historic event. And gratitude should be our disposition. as we return thanks to God and call upon Him, even as we are in the season of Advent, that we soon launch us onto Christmas, that the peace that Christmas gives may never lack in us, that the joy that Christmas brings may be our portion, that this celebration may kick off so many other celebrations in our life, that we who are here today singing and glorifying God may continue to do so all the days of our life. This we ask and pray for through Christ our Lord. May we now stand, and I will call on Father Jerome and Olorunmi here to organize the prayers of the faithful. We will have prayers for EduCare students, for management and staff of EduCare, for EduCare parents, for the MT and family of EduCare, and for River State and Nigeria. Of course, we shall pray for ourselves, and I suppose we have prepared for this.
Those who pray for us, please come forward. Almighty God, our Father, we give you thanks and glory, adoration. We thank you for this day. We have gathered to celebrate for the 35th anniversary of EduCare. We beg and ask you to continue to give us the grace and blessings. At the end of time, all glory, honor, we are calling to your name. Our response shall be, Lord, hear our prayers. And we respond,
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for our pupils. May God send His Spirit upon our pupils and fill them with His wisdom and blessings. Lord, we want more for our students than mere survival. We pray that you will make them outstanding leaders, imitators of your character, and secure in their faith. We pray, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for the management and staff of EduCare, that they may continually be filled with the grace and the patience and the knowledge and the strength to handle and take care of the two children and pass them to their family.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For EduCare parents, let us pray and hand EduCare parents over to God, that He will guide and guide them, that He will preserve them and protect them from the eyes of the evil ones. Let us pray that God will bless the works of their hands so that they will be able to provide for their families, especially for these little ones they have put under our care. We pray thee, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for our Father. May they remain God and our family. May they continue to have the strength and wisdom to support the able leaders of this establishment. We pray, O Lord.
Let us pray for our state and our country, Nigeria. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this wonderful day. We thank you for our country, Nigeria. We pray for good governance, prosperity, and security of lives. Oh God, give us the wisdom. We let good leaders
my secondary campus educator at the students.
And ours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father. Lord, you gave us your only Son to free us from death and from every evil. Mercifully accept this sacrifice in gratitude for saving us from our distress through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, all powerful and ever living God, always and everywhere to give your thanks to Jesus Christ, our Lord. When he humbled himself to come among us as a man, he fulfilled the plan he formed long ago and opened for us the way to salvation. Now we watch for the day, hoping that the salvation promised us will be ours, when Christ our Lord will come again in his glory. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim their glory as we join in the unending hymn of praise. Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving your thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give up thanks that have held us worthy to be your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Cabinet, our Bishop, Patrick, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and spouse Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
With him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we have the courage to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we are with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance with your will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirits.
We will now give to each other a sign of peace.
who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Those who can sit, those who can kneel, and give you peace.
God, who takes away the sins of the world, happy are those who are called to his banquet.
Angelicus, and Miss Elizabeth Redcoffee. Prayers will be offered and holy water will be sprinkled.
Thank you.
May we be seated, please. It's now time for one or two speeches. If there's going to be an announcement, it's now time for it. Or to appreciate those who have shown presence here today. Or if Lady John has something to say to the crowd, it's also time for her. But I will now invite the administrator to welcome all who have come and maybe to remind us of tomorrow.
Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to thank everybody for making time for today's event. Well, God may give the glory, even though many of my parents are not here. Tomorrow, we are starting at 2 o'clock prompt. And it's going to be a coordination of our Christmas party and anniversary. So I believe all of you will be present. Thank you for making time. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I don't know whether Lady John would like to address the audience. Please listen attentively.
Reverend Father, Professor, Dean, and Innocent, Father Jerome, all our dear parents, the administrator of EduCare, Mrs. Granville and her staff, all the children and friends of EduCare. Today is not a speech day, this is a mass. So I will reserve my speech for tomorrow. I thank you all for coming to join EduCare in this very special day, special thanksgiving to God. As Reverend Father Innocent has already mentioned, the mustard seed. There could have been no other gospel than the one they chose for this mass. It was very apt. Thank you very much for all your kind words, Father Innocent. You are always very supportive of us. And Father Jerome also, thank you. And my dear parents, it has been a pleasure to worship with you this afternoon. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Lady John. And that being, I thank Father Jerome for being here with me. And I thank the Reverend Sisters who also came along to share in today's joy. And I thank the choir for making it happen, singing unto God's glory. A round of applause for them, please. Thank you. I also thank the altar servers.
No.
The program sisters.
So no. Not right.
I'm sorry, I just want to say a big thank you also for the Reverend Sisters who came to grace the occasion. Thank you.
Thank you, Lady John. We thank the other servers as well from Greenwood Secondary School for being here. They were here on time and they have done all they need to do. We want to appreciate the administrator and the team working with her for everything they have done to get this done, and also for the presence they have brought to the altar this day. We pray God to replenish whatever they have spent. We thank Lady John for always calling on us, always calling on God, always being who she is, a noble lady, a generous soul, a caregiver. We thank God and pray God for more life upon her, more strength upon her, and that the EduCare establishment may continue to grow from strength to strength through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God bless and keep you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us go in peace, for this mass is ended.
Father,